Yeah, the players were saying that your basic message after the game was pretty simple, that you need to play better. Is that something?
No, just, you know, everybody's got to take ownership and responsibility. That starts with me. And, you know, it's in situations like this, the little things can turn into big things. Details, things like that. And you know, the message is basically, look, it's everybody's going to look at themselves first and how they can be better, including me and coaches, and then move on. Because, you know, I think just like earlier in the year, you know, these situations that come up, if they come up, you know, there's not a lot you can do about this, but you don't want this performance to keep bleeding into the rest of the season, was the message. And so, we need to fix the things that that we can, and then continue playing with effort, and then get to put our best people on the field to give us a chance to win.
Coach, Utah scored touchdowns on four of their first drives,
yep.
First five drives. Offensively, what were they doing to kind of keep your defense on the field?
Well, the first thing that kept them on the field was, I think, the first series that they completed three third and longs, right? One by penalty, a couple runs. Those third and longs kept them on the field and really set the tone for the first drive. And we give Utah credit because of, you know, they're able to execute. But the three third long situations, in the, if I'm not mistaken, in the first series and the second series, one third and extra one that they were able to complete and stay on the field. So really, those first two series really set the tone for the game. Based on those third down situations and I think maybe a penalty in the second one, right? But they, you know, but you give Utah credit because of how they approached it and they executed and we didn't in those third long situations, which kept them on the field maybe, what, 6-7 minutes in the first drive.
Yeah, so it was 7-13.
Yeah, that set the tone for the rest of the game.
How would you assess the state of their quarterback situation?
Well, the situation was that I think it said at halftime on television that, you know, that last series that Khalil was in there, you know, I was concerned about him not being able to move at all. You know, he running was out of the question, and even drop back and handing it off. So, you know, that you know, we're always going to start with player safety first, and so, you know. We had an opportunity. I thought that Brett, you know, wanted to give him a shot, really to run a 2-minute offense before the half. I thought that he did move the team, and that earned him the right to start the second half. And, you know, all in all, I got to go back and look at it, but I thought that in a tough situation, I thought that he operated with the poise. I thought that he looked comfortable. And, you know, in a really tough situation, I thought that in a tough environment, I thought he handled it very, very well, was mature. You know, and really at that time was, you know, really kind of moved the ball. So it gave him opportunity, you know, that to, because of his maturity, because of, you know, where he is, a little bit more experienced, you know, he didn't do anything that warranted him being taken out of the game. I thought that, you know, I have to look at it again, I always do, but I thought he operated fairly well based on the situation that he was in.
So where do you go from here at that position, given that Google's ankle is sort of flaring up?
Yeah, we got to see, you know, you know, tonight was different than probably than the last 5-6 weeks because it, you know, after the sack, you know, it was you know, it was clear to me that, he could barely move out there. And I think it was unlike maybe Oregon State where I called a timeout. I think it was maybe what, 4 weeks ago? Called a timeout and just let him walk around and he pointed back at me, yeah, I'm good. But I didn't see that tonight. I saw a player that could barely move. So we had to make the move. So we'll assess that next week, you know, where he is physically. I think, you know, Rhett did some good things. Jamari's still coming on. And, you know, KD's guys are going to get reps, particularly if Khalil can't practice early in the week. You know, we've got an extra day, really. But we'll assess that and see where we are next week.
Did Lath get re-injured, or did you just take him out because the game was kind of getting out of hand?
He just couldn't move around the way he needed to move tonight against this team.
Are you surprised that the defense struggled as much as it did, given how well that unit had played since maybe the middle of the third quarter against USC?
Yeah, I thought, I'll put it that way. I was surprised. I mean, this is a really physical team, a good team. I think, and don't get me wrong, like I said, how many rushes they have? 46. So, you know, I was surprised, but, you know, the third down situations in the first two drives, we had an opportunity to get off the field in those first two drives. And that's not discrediting Utah at all, because they executed and we didn't. And then gave one away on a penalty, on a, you know. You can't, against the types of teams that we're playing, you can't continue to give up third and long situations, third and six, seven plus, and stay on the field for 7 minutes on the opening drive. You know, that as I said, that set the tone for the game.
On the flip side, you guys had some fourth and short situations offensively that you weren't able to
control.
What's going on in those plays?
Yeah, exactly. You know, we've got our yeah, I got to go back and look at that too. But, you know, we tried to run it, and you know, we couldn't. And you know, we tried a couple different schemes to run on fourth and short, and we weren't able to make them. And so, you know, at a certain point, you know, it's football becomes some winning your one-on-ones, and. Yeah, we weren't able to do that tonight, whether it was to run it on fourth and short or to throw it against man coverage and get open consistently. So, you know, that being said, you know, in those situations when you can't do that, you know, the other team has a lot to do with it, but at a certain point, football is about one-on-ones and we didn't win tonight.
Did you have any issue with Utah running a big punt at that point in the game with the score being what it was?
It's football. You know, I think basically their guy, based on what I've seen over the years, he's a talented punter. Best in the country last year, right? And looking at some different video and things, I think he just pulls it down sometimes when he sees it. So, you know, he's done it before.
Time for one more question.
Are you frustrated that you haven't been able to kind of put together a sustained period of good ball, lose two, win two, and then like lose, win, lose kind of every other week?
Yeah, I mean, of course I'm frustrated. You know, and I think, you know, our team is too. I think this is the short week this week, you know, changed up some things to give our guys a little better chance. I think, you know, we'll see with this week. You know, just because it's back to more of a normal week for us from a preparation standpoint. But yeah, that's frustrating. And it gets back to consistency, right? Which we've talked about. We've talked about, you know, this whole season. We've also talked about third downs. And even though we have gotten better in our turnover margin, which actually, you know, has helped, you know, third down efficiency, both offensively and defensively, have not been where we want it to be, and that's translated into a situation like tonight.
All right, thank you, folks. Thank you.